Good afternoon to everyone. Myself Gurjot Kaur, studying in plus one class commerce. Today we are gathered here for a panel discussion on eradicate corruption and build a new India. What is corruption? A common definition of public corruption is the misuse of public office for private gain. For example, bribery in various government offices, medical officials, unnecessary gaining money from patients. Therefore, to talk about how the corruption is spreading and why, causes and how it should be eradicated from our country, we have invited some panelists from various fields like politicians, educationists, businessmen, doctors and social workers from NGO. Let's start the discussion. My first question, the corruption starts from us. What do you think? How the people encourage the corruption? What are your views, social workers?
Corruption is mainly encouraged when we start giving and taking bribes. It is when we are focusing on money mind. We have a money minded attitude. We can say that it just starts from politicians. It has its birth from politicians. When we have to make our work, we have to go make rounds of their offices. If we just deposit money in their office, our work is done in just 1 or 2 days.
Politicians, how do you defend yourself?
It is only the political parties that have taken the India to this level.
You can't make us only responsible for this corruption. We are not the born leaders. We are not everyone. We are the leaders from you. We are the people from you. You have elected us to represent you. You have given us the power.
But from my point of view, the education is the basis of one's life. So the cheating cases and the bribes in the CBSE boards, this is the education level. So in my opinion, education is the basis of corruption.
If you are saying that education is the basis of corruption, then I would like to throw light on the world leading scientists from India, our topping teachers. Now you all are sitting here just because of us. We are nation builders. How can you make us responsible for this only?
But CBSE cases are too much.
I think we should also look at the positive side of this, because negative side being one side, we have created this nation and we are the nation builders. So I think I agree with this statement that some corruption may also occur, because everything could not be perfect, but most of I think its responsibility goes to other sectors.
Excuse me, but educationists take funds, donations for what purpose? On how much amount?
Yes, it is true to say that for getting admissions in very good institutions, the doctor's offer is very costly. But we have the equipments that are very much advanced. So we have to keep a pace with this. So in order to keep this in mind, the treatment will be costly. But if you say about the bribes in the medical field, so I would like to say that common people, they can't give bribes of lakh or crores. These are the only famous personalities, businessmen, political leaders who give the bribes to the medical doctors for their early treatment and many other issues.
Yes, you are right. Private businessmen give bribe for approval of their many projects. So businessmen, you are too corrupted. How will you defend yourself?
Yes, it is somewhere true that bribing takes place in business, but we can't fully say that business is corrupted.
Well, you can do anything for profits.
No, everything is done for a profit. They are doctors. Why they are doctors? They are doctor for a profit. They are educationists. They are earning money. Everything is done for profit. So why the allegation
no,
of profit
only
making is...
Everybody is here from the, only for the profit only.
No, only money can't be, we can say... social welfare, society is also matters.
So how can we forget those facts that how business has made India that level as it is today? India has...
India was ranked 41 a few years ago, but now we have, with our hard work, we made it at the 9th rank.
What about the economic development, which is only because of the business?
Okay. At some extent, yes, it's true that you have developed a lot, but there is some corruption. How can you end this thing from the business?
Yeah, there is corruption. I agree with this that there is corruption, but everything has good face and bad face. We can't say that everything is bad only. Look at the good faces also.
But we have also to remove the good bad face.
Yeah, we are.
How will you do that?
Government should apply some rules. It should implement those rules which should remove the corruption.
We have introduced the demonetization. So what about implementation? Is there an implementation? Too much black money has removed from the country.
But there are some moral values in a businessman. But there is need for some moral values in a businessman. Money can't buy all things for you.
But what about money, development which we have made?
Development can be much more to at today level.
In the few years you can see that.
That will take too much time.
But what about the bribes that you have taken to get
only
the
only we are not taking the bribes. Educationists are taking the bribes. Doctors are taking the bribes. Only we are not taking the bribes.
You are even the only other country.
We can't control them, but we can.
You can control if you initiate this thing that we will not buy the votes or anything.
Yes. Yes, we can make the provision as the election commission also had made the rules to remove the vote scam.
And making provisions are far apart. The corruption is existing within your parties. You give candidates, you allow only those candidates that can raise money in the election.
You provide
the what about that you spend so much money on the election?
It can use the welfare of people also. The money you use in the election.
You are raising questions was that we have so black money, what about your?
But we want to have our party in the current. So we have to do this. It is commonly
but not
seen
with the money on
one by one, please.
It is commonly seen that the accounts of officials of the parties are never audited, but they should be because they we should also know that how much money are you having? You are earning. You are filling your pockets with public's money.
It's just pocket always.
You can see
these are not used for the welfare.
You can see the roads and the welfare and development programs in the India. India has raised this high because of the government and the taxes paid by youth that are used in the development programs.
But why all these development programs are started when the elections are near?
Yes. It's also true that when the elections came here.
Being Human, that is run by Salman Khan, an actor, is a very good foundation. I accept that some NGOs are there at using illegal works, but we can't deny the positive works.
You have started some
Click photo page, that is a Facebook page, click a photo, that is a very much good campaign started by many NGOs. For the lost child, click a photo and upload on Facebook page, that is only the work done by NGOs.
But
NGOs
you have started supporting some orphanages also, you are taking the money also. But the children, you are involving them in the child labor. Then what about the money that you are getting?
But I'm repeating my words that all the NGOs are not of same time. Quanto project is the major project started in India.
if you talk about the children, so the government officials as well as common people are making organizations to resolve them. Police and the administrative officials should check it when the children are sent for illegal work. Isn't it duty for the policemen or government officials?
It's also duty to keep the children in the...
Major part of the corruption starts from the politicians.
But we only can't develop the country. We all have to be together.
To develop a country, businessmen also play an important role. Yes. Today, business has become house of money. Open a business, get money. They give no
the
bills.
The main motive is profits. Yes.
Non-materialistic nature of persons.
As we have started the GST, then why are they not showing the bills?
Yes.
All the bills?
No bills are given.
Businessman,
we are showing the bills. You have seen, and also in the demonetization, a lot of black money has been raised in our country. So what about that? You have not shown that.
Is not there.
Most
money
from the
middle
party loans.
Yes. The main.
Most
again, politicians. Okay, let's stop this. Okay, education.
It would be uploaded if we just make laws and amend heavy punishments for the defaulters. Instead, every person should build up a morale that he or she should not take part in this monstrous evil. And we should also strengthen legal foundations and also aware the persons related with the educational institutions so that this problem should be.
Politicians, how will you make your efforts in eradicating corruption?
I would like to throw the light on the several anti-corruption provisions by the India. Indian Penal Code 1860, Procedure Section of Income Tax Act 1961. The Prevention of Money Laundering Act 2002 and many more acts are made by Indian government. We can implement in more areas of the India and control the corruption.
Social worker, you want to say something?
Yes, educationists have said to build up a morale. So isn't it duty of educationists to build the morale in children?
To take part together and remove this thing totally from our India. We have to take a pledge that we will never ever do corruption, take bribes or anything that will take down us. And the punishments, judiciary system, if it is they are doing their job properly, giving judgments on right thing and on time, then it can be reduced. And the punishments should be so hard that if a person wants to do the corrupt thing, then he will dare to do that, that he will can be hanged. So let's take a pledge, everyone.
Despite all that we have done for corruption in our country,
we will not be further.
We support CBSE's initiatives to
eradicate
corruption and celebrate Vigilance Awareness Week.